Director Faden here. Send backup to my location.
Let's put him down!
This is Director Faden. I require backup at this location.
Nice to see a director out in the field.
Thank you.
Hartman won't be a problem anymore, Exton. But Investigations needs someone to run it. Interested?
I've seen what happens to sector heads, ma'am. No, thank you. Ma'am, I'm getting something on my terminal here, an AWE alert from Bright Falls, Washington. But it might be a glitch. The date's all wrong, a couple of years in the future. And we're in lockdown, there shouldn't be any incoming signals.
Maybe it was active before we went into lockdown? Are there agents on site?
Let me check. Agent Estevez is the field agent in charge of monitoring the site, so she should be there to let us know if the situation has been through any major changes recently.
If the alarm's true, then so is the reason for the alarm. The effect must follow the cause. It's happening again. I'll return. You have been warned.
must be where they sent him. Kinda looks like he killed himself. I wonder if they treated him as badly.
Faden here. Dispatch a ranger to this location. This is the director. I need backup at my level.
Thank you.
Director Faden here. Send backup to my location.
Nice to see a director out in the field.
I need the containment protocols for every altered item or object of power with an audio relay.
Man, I never thought I'd be working in the executive sector. Look at me now, Ma.
What do you think of Marshall?
Marshall? Marshall's a fucking badass. Rangers could not ask for a better leader. She's a little, intense, but given the stuff she's seen, I'm not surprised. She does have a bad habit of disappearing, though.
Where does she go?
Last time she vanished, I did some digging into the security logs. I found camera footage of her entering the quarry. She was down there alone for days. Now, typically that's not allowed, but Marshall is kind of above the rules.
I wonder what she finds so interesting in the quarry. I have to go.
Me too. You're not the only one who's busy, you know.
Welcome back, Jesse. Hi, Jesse. I should get going. Don't let me hold you up.
I need the containment protocols for every altered item or object.
Hello.
Mark Gibson, male, age 28, returned from the astral plane approximately 13 minutes ago. This was his 21st dive. Patient is experiencing migraine-like pain, intense pressure behind the eyes, and partial blindness. He has no recollection of his time in the astral plane and appears severely disoriented. Preliminary examination revealed no immediate cause, so we will be sending patient for x-rays and... What the fuck is that thing? God, it burst right out of him. Call Black! Get Marshall!
Gotten in here too? All right. Let's get cleaning, she said, cocking her gun.
Thank you.
That must be one of the missing ultimatums. Wait, how did I get back here? I found all those missing altered items.
All of them? Wow, you have a gift, ma'am. But those weren't all of the altered items missing from the Panopticon. The hiss must be making them restless. We've had several more containment breaches.
How many of these things did he lose?
How many?
Just a couple. Should be no problem for you. I really appreciate your help. Really, just super.
I'll see you later, Langston.
I'll be here, like always.
exact process of how an altered item is born eludes us. We find them in the aftermath of altered world events. They take the form of everyday objects, ever present in our lives, constantly evoked in the thoughts of millions of people, now infused with unpredictable energies. They're altered. The superstitious would call them cursed. Now, are altered items sentient? Not quite. They're often fixated, programmed almost to cause... certain events to happen over and over again. While generally less potent than objects of power, they are not able to be controlled. Left unchecked, they can be highly dangerous. To study altered items, we contain them in Panopticon.
Great. More clocks. What is that? It's making more cops? The Rangers had such a hard time with that one. Yeah. only thing creepier than one mannequin is a few dozen of the damn things. No more mannequins.
Thank you.
There you are.
Thank you.
clearing.
Thank you.
I guess the Bureau should start looking. For a new head of communications.
You're listening to America Overnight, now in our 29th year, lifting the veil between fiction and reality. Thank you for staying up with us. I've been getting a lot of calls about this meteor in Sterling, Colorado. There are reports of a large spherical container that crash-landed in a field outside town. Some government people reportedly took it away. Now, we happen to broadcast from Colorado, and Sterling isn't far. I drove down myself to check it out with members of the America Overnight team. I don't need to tell you, it wasn't long before we found pieces of metal debris scattered in a field. Listeners, this is yet another instance of an unidentified flying object, or UFO, entering our airspace and crashing. That the government took away the evidence undercover of darkness only compounds the fact that these are more than likely visitors from beyond our planet, or dare I say, solar system. Head on over to our website to see pictures of the spacecraft pieces we uncovered. And while you're doing that, our sponsors would like your ear. America Overnight will be right back.